I wanted to show you this to get you a little excited as our kids are about global climate change.
Competing in one of six challenges, technical, scientific, engineering, fine arts, improvisational, and service learning. Students imagine, plan, design, build, and create their solutions for a chance to earn a coveted spot at the world's largest celebration of creativity.
Very emotional because I'm so proud of them and how they can kind of see that.
I'm Ella Nichols, a second grader, and in our skit, I'm the queen.
I'm Riley Laughlin, and I'm in seventh grade, and I'm the princess in the skit.
I'm Tony Cassandra, I'm in seventh grade, and I'm the peasant. I have to wear this costume because someone wouldn't be able to be here.
Nico Ramirez is at a baseball game tonight, and this is their trophy. My favorite moment with this group, we're all sitting on this gym floor, and they called their name, Columbiana Southside Middle School, and they all sat there. And then they kind of looked at me, and I'm like, you know what? Go! You won! They were so excited for them. They just kind of sat there, they really didn't have any idea, and it was just so precious to see them that excited. Everyone came back with some tears, but they were really happy, and I was so proud of all of them. They did a great job solving their scientific challenge.
Good job.
My next team is an improv team. Come on up. They get to have this year a box of props. And I'm going to have Harmony coming up too. She's on my high school improv team, and everyone else has a job. And or driving class that is working. But my middle level improv team, this is the box that every prop they might want has to fit in. And it can be 13 by 13 and that is it. Any bigger and they don't let you take your box in. So they have all kinds of wonderful things from headbands to scarves and even paper plates and pipe cleaners are in here. And one of my favorite moments was Joey Baylor got to be a warrior. They have to come up with a stock character and they draw that out of a fishbowl or something right before they go on. And a genre that they know ahead that they haven't, they aren't sure which one they'll get. And then they give them a story prompt on the way. Harmony, can you give me an example of a genre and character that you might have?
At States, we had a pilot, and we had to do a horror skit.
And then there's something else strange that happens and to like, they throw at you.
They'll tell you, like, maybe, like, the pilot has to sing the whole time, and the grass is turning purple, and your skit has to be a horror genre. And then you have to do that three times, and you only have 3 minutes to plan your whole skit and perform.
Get your costumes on, plan, prepare, and perform in 3 minutes, three different times.
Wow. Yeah,
so that's their thing. So Joey was a warrior one day. I love the hair. And one of our top characters is Richarella. She was in our fairy tale, and she had high praise from all the appraisers. They all laughed whenever she was there. So we were very excited to have them. But you can see how they can turn just anything into a costume or something different. And you can see how they're using these now. Every 3 minutes they change. So this may be something completely different than the next skit, or maybe they won't even use it and it'll be something else. And so improv is quick thinking right on the spot, and they did a really good job. The middle school team placed third, and I wasn't ready for it because they had just announced the other team, and then this one came, and I was like, oh my goodness! So if you would introduce yourselves, and we have a couple missing members tonight, but you can tell who they are too.
Gotcha. I'm Joey Baylor, Mrs. Baylor's son.
And these are all six members.
I'm Kim Carter.
I'm Allison Smith.
I'm Chelsea Chafee.
And we have Mia Strohecker, Delaney Finsley, and Preston Dawson for us in this group. And then Harmony's representing our high school improv team, which placed second at the competition, and they did an excellent job. I will have the kids come over sometime and show you some of their fun characters. One of my favorite is Logan Pasco as a construction worker. she had the jackhammer going, and it was all imaginary props for her.
Wow.
It was excellent. All the teams have an instant challenge part that they do as well. So in addition to what they practice and prep for, they also have instant challenge where they go into a room and they can be asked to do anything. And they can't tell you because it's not past global finals yet. So they are sworn to secrecy and they are not allowed to say anything. So these are those two teams. And before we get to our last team going on to global finals, we have another team that was absolutely fabulous and has really done a lot. This team placed first at the regional competition. This is another high school team. They did Ready, Willing, and Fable, which is a double DI problem. They have to do a service project in addition to your normal DI skit, instant challenge, and everything, and they...
Perfect. No, like sideways.
Went to... Basement. Right there is perfect. They went to the city council and talked to them about having a day when they could go around, they wanted to pass out flyers, and they wanted to make a collection because part of their service project was to come up with something that they could do, and I'm going to let them
That's
talk about
it.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. And they have made a TP of TP.
That was their TP. That has lived in my classroom for 2 months.
So we paired together with our Interact inside of the high school, and we had the idea of the toilet paper collection as well as the dish soap, and we had a lot of fun with it. When we talked to the city council and everybody to get it approved, it was just a really interesting experience. Quite a lot of fun. Yeah.
Explain why you collected those particular items.
We decided to collect toilet paper and dish soap because those are items that people cannot purchase with food stamps. So the people who really, really need them, unfortunately, cannot get to them. So we decided to collect it. We set a goal of collecting 400 rolls of toilet paper and about 100 bottles of dish soap, and we blew our goal out of the water. We collected 700 toilet paper rolls, and unfortunately, only got like 73 bottles of dish soap, but we still collected some, so.
Where did they go?
The dish soap was going to Oasis, here.
No,
dish soap was.
Dish soap.
Oh, okay. Then I.
That was our line.
Well, and then the toilet paper is going to the Oasis. And it's just, we talked to them, and it's going to be enough for the summer. It's the whole, like, for St. John's, they don't have to purchase those items now. They'll have enough to go throughout the summer, and then they can purchase other items they need. So we helped
the lady
that
was in the street was actually in tears when we talked to her, and I ran into her church, and she was very, very appreciative. And again, they said to you they normally buy this amount every 3 months, so this was going to cover 3 months instead of just what they normally have to purchase for 1 month.
How did that make you feel?
It was an interesting experience, yeah.
Their central challenge placed second in the state. Their instant challenge wasn't quite as high, so they are not moving on this year, but they have all said they are determined that they are not going to give up their global domain, and I have to
come back. And my brother is going to be a senior next year, so let's hope that we can do it together.
Yeah. Russell Mercy is also on the team, and Marissa McCoskey, and this is?
I'm Rebecca Silver.
I'm Zoe Finsley, and I'm in 8th grade.
So she joined a high school team because there was not one open for her in middle school, and she's actually really good friends with all of these kids from band and taking some classes at high school. Okay, now we're going to do a little movement because we have a team that plays first at Regents, first at State, and that is really great. And they have some really innovative things. At the state competition, they also won a Renaissance Award, and that is given for either a very technical or very artistic thing that they've done. And I can't explain it, but my jaw dropped when I saw it, and I was so excited. I've been talking about it for weeks. I mean, Mr. Wolk, you have to come and see this. You're going to really want to see it. So I did convince him, and we're going to go out into the commons so you can see the invention that they created. And I'm going to let them tell you all about it because they should know so much more.